instrument is the violin.
The best thing about my instrument is that Miss Saara plays it.
I really love that. I get to play the high strings and the violin.
During this year in beginning strings, we have learned, for example, how to play our concert songs that we're going to perform for you guys.
Today we will perform three songs for you. One is called Rock on Strings. You will hear how we play heavier rock style rhythms, and Miss Marilee will join us playing at the piano, and Prin will play the drums.
Our second piece is called Prelude and Fugue. This song really challenged us when we have learned how to play the classical refined sound and how to play a fugue.
Do you know, by the way, what a fugue is? Well, I'll tell you. It means a composition where a short melody is introduced by one group of instruments and then it's taken up by another group and then another. So it's really cool how the same melody develops when it's played by different groups at different times.
Our last song, Dragon Hunter, is our favorite. We know you will enjoy the fast rhythms of this exciting piece. Thank you.
Almost forgot this. So in orchestra, we have four different instruments. We don't have a double bass in the beginning strings yet, but we have violins, we have violas and cellos. And for violins, there's usually two parts in every song, violin one and violin two. And we switch between the songs so everybody gets to play different parts.
Thank you.
to say how proud of I am for these students and their hard work they have really put in this year. They have been truly an enjoyment to teach. I just love meeting them every week. And looking forward to next year when they will be an intermediate orchestra.
Thank you.
next song, guest soloist, one of you in the audience is up for a surprise because we need a soloist for this song. Any volunteers? Any volunteers? I'm trying to think of some parents. You know what? I think we will ask Mr. Stephen Lattice to step on the stage. Come up, come up. So, Mr. Stephen's whole family plays some instrument, but to my knowledge, he doesn't. So now he can get to try violin. Please come in front. That's where the soloist usually stands. All the way here. This is our fourth performance this year, right? Or already our fourth concert. So we have had a full year of concerts, and I'm super proud of them. And next year, we'll meet in the advanced. Okay, now, Gauntlet.
Mr. Christian Sarazen, and I'm the choir director here as well as the band director. This is the middle school choir that you see before you. We have three songs for you this evening, and I hope you enjoy. First song will be introduced by me.
The Wellerman is a traditional sea shanty that originated in the mid-19th century among the sailors who worked in the whaling industry. The song tells the story of the crew of a whaling ship waiting for the arrival of the Wellerman, a supply ship that would bring them food and other necessities. The Wellerman was a crucial part of the whaling fleet, and the crew's ability to survive often depended on its timely arrival. This song gained a resurgence in popularity a couple of years ago, when a group from New Zealand went viral on social media. The song's catchy melody and infectious rhythm have made it a hit with modern audiences, and hundreds of covers and remixes have since been created and shared. We hope you enjoy our remix, arranged for us by Mr. Christian, Saara, Sebo, and Karis all have short solos.
His version of Over the Rainbow, complete with ukuleles, played by Tiara, Mami, and Rainbow. Tiara will also be our soloist.
Thank you. this beloved song from the hit 2017 movie musical, The Greatest Showman, was written by Ben Pusick and Justin Hall. This arrangement by Matt Huff is designed for a three-part choir and is a beautiful and moving rendition of the original song, capturing the emotional depth and beauty of the lyrics and melody. It is an ideal piece for choirs looking to showcase their vocal talents and provide audiences with an uplifting and inspiring musical experience. Grant and Cream are our featured soloists.
That I Thank you.
Anasazi is a Navajo word that means angel. It refers to an ancient Native American American civilization that lived in the southwestern United States from around 200 BC to 1380. They are known for their impressive architecture, including cliff dwellings and pueblos, as well as their sophisticated agriculture practices. Composer John Edmondson was inspired by their culture and their history, and it brings it to life in this piece. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
warm-up note and a tuning note because they also have not played in over an hour.
Thank you. Sunset on the Sahara is actually a grade one beginning band arrangement. Translation, very easy. But then we decided to play it in cut time, which means playing every note with half its original value, making the song sound twice as fast. We think you'll agree that we've mastered cut time as we've performed this fun, fast piece for you, and that you'll imagine yourself on an adventure amongst the sand dunes of the Sahara.
Thank you.
of schools are able to do this, especially at the intermediate level. So this is a real treat to be able to combine groups. So our final piece for you tonight is from a movie. So maybe some of you have seen it, an old movie that has made a sequel that recently to make it a little more famous. But here to introduce it, I'll turn it over.
Orchestra arrangement by a micro story for you today. We hope you enjoy.